On behalf of the Royal British Legion, Old Park, Cave Hill, Blunt, I welcome you all to this memorial service. A special welcome to our friends in the Royal Highland Fusiliers, joined by friends from the Royal Scots, the King's Own Scottish Borders, the Black Watch, the Ulster Defence Regiment, and the Royal British Legion Riders. We're gathered here this afternoon to remember with pride, thanksgiving and sorrow the lives of Fusiliers John McCaig, Susan McCaig and Dougal McCaughey, who were brutally murdered by cards at this very spot 49 years ago this Tuesday, the 10th of March 1971. Let us begin our word of service with prayer. Let us pray. Lord God Almighty, bless us in our service and remembrance this day here at White Bread, as we come before you to honour the memory of three young soldiers so callously murdered at this place. We come to honour their memory and to seek comfort for those who still mourn their loss. Lord, remember all those who made the supreme sacrifice in the cause of peace here in Northern Ireland. All those who suffered at the hands of terrorists, each year with memories of someone they knew who were victims of the Troubles. This afternoon, we focus our thoughts and memories of thanksgiving and pride and our remembrance of Fusiliers John McCaig, Joseph McCaig and Dougal McCaughey. Jesus God, we pray for comfort for the families of these three young men, for whom on a daily basis the loss is still real. We pray for their colleagues to serve with them and the Royal Highland Fusiliers. May their memories never fade. Lord, we also pray for those who seek justice, those who work tirelessly to see the murders of these three lads brought to justice. May this service show that men in our beloved province recognise the sacrifice of those who serve. We haven't forgotten their sacrifice, as we display our gratitude to all as we honour the memory of these three Scottish soldiers. Lord, may each one present know your blessing and strength. Be with us all during this service of remembrance. For we ask it in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Saviour. Amen.
Amen.
Our Bible reading this afternoon is taken from John 15, read for us by Assistant Chaplain of the British Legion Branch, Linda Gibson. Let us join in singing the words of that great hymn, Abide With Me. So find the words in your order of service. Let us sing together, Abide With Me.
Thank you.
in memory. John McCaig, Joseph McCaig, and Dougal McCaughey of the Royal Highland Fusiliers, who were brutally murdered at this spot, while at the same time offering Christian hope in the face of such evil. Honouring those who served their country is something that comes natural to many of us in Northern Ireland. We see serving King and country, Queen and Commonwealth, as part of our duty as loyal citizens. And so we naturally hold those who take the Queen's shilling and don the uniform in the highest esteem. We honour those who serve, and especially those who sacrificed their all, because they did so defending our freedom. Whether in times of war or combating terrorism, wherever found, they fought. These three lads came to Northern Ireland to protect all its citizens and defeat those who sought through murder and mayhem to impose their will. And in the case of those who murdered them, to cause the United Kingdom to abandon this part of the Union. Put it simply, these three young jocks died at the hands of those who, through terror and violence, sought a united Ireland. As the song puts it, the boys came to Belfast, their country to serve. That is why we honour them. They came to this province to serve their country. And as the song goes on, they suffered a fate that no man should deserve. We honour all who serve. But today we particularly remember John, Joseph and Dougal. Because of the cowardly way they were murdered. Because of their youth. Because they were off duty. Because they were unarmed, because they were third, fourth and fifth members of the regular army to be murdered. Because we remember these three jobs, it does not mean we remember others who served and died any less. In honouring these three soldiers, we honour all who give their lives in the service of the Crown during what we call the Troubles. It was the nature of these murders, the evil that was carried out on this country then that touched the hearts of the people of Northern Ireland, of this community, of each one here. Indeed, 49 years after that fateful night, it is still remembered by many. Indeed, the recent Spotlight programme showed new generations the sordid details of their fate, the callousness of the killers, and the reaction of the people of this city and beyond, who were horrified by their murders. We said then, and this service shows, we will never forget. We will remember the boys who came to Belfast, our country to serve. Their memory is a focal point for our remembrance of everyone who served, and especially those who give their all. Men and women from all regiments and formations. Those who stood between democracy and anarchy. Those who on a daily basis fought terrorism. Those who served this country proudly, diligently and bravely. But as I said at the beginning, it's my task this day to also bring hope to all gathered here. Hope in the light of the Spotlight programme that shows one of those suspected of being involved in this foul deed living openly in the Republic of Ireland. Where is the hope of justice? Hope in the light of a society where those who are proud of their terrorist past and glory in the horror of this and other atrocities aren't positions of power and authority. Where is the hope of repentance? Where was hope on the 10th of March 1971? Can there be hope amidst the evil of such events? Can there be hope in a land where those who fail to show any shame or remorse for murders such as this and hundreds more are elected to rule and govern? I would have to say, no. No hope if hope was merely our own wishful thinking. I would have to say no if we were hoping the leopard would change its spots. I think we'd wait a long time. But there is hope. The only true hope to face the horrors of terrorism. The only true hope to face the legacy of the Troubles and the rewriting of history that cast the terrorists as victims. The only hope that allows us to face this life, with all its difficulties, unfairness and anger, is the Christian hope is offered through the gospel of Jesus Christ. Jesus knew what betrayal looked like. Jesus knew what it was like to die without a fair trial. He knew what it was like to be murdered at the side of the road. But Jesus came to die and to be raised to life, to offer us hope. Not a forlorn hope, but a certain hope. And Jesus will come back one day to make all things right. On that day, all people will be judged with perfect justice. No amount of distance or time or lies will hide the guilty. Without remorse or repentance, the guilty will be sentenced, and their lives of separation from God will culminate in endless anguish. But those who accept the gift of salvation through faith in Jesus will be declared right with God. They will enjoy life as God designed it, without selfishness, grief, hatred, pain, sorrow, abuse, terror, suffering, and death. And God will satisfy their deepest longing. He'll make everything good and right again, and will be that way forever. That's the Christian hope. Now if we think about the suffering and pain in this world, the injustice, the evil, the terror, take comfort from knowing that in time God will make every wrong right. We don't need to take matters into our own hands. If justice is not done in this life, it will be in the next. We are not the final judge or authority. As is written in Revelation 21, the day will come when evil will be at the end, when bitterness will be healed and justice will reign. He will wipe every tear from their eyes, and there will be no more death, our sorrow, our crying, our pain. All these things are gone forever. Today, we honour and remember Fusilier John McCaig, Fusilier Joseph McCaig, Fusilier Dougal McCaughey. The hope that will see this wrong righted, the hope that will see the truth be told and justice finally and perfectly done, is found in the one we call our Saviour, Redeemer and Friend, Jesus Christ. May the hope he offers be your portion this day and always. Amen. So we're going to have an act of remembrance and ask everyone who's taken part in that act of remembrance and the collective to please come forward at this time. We're going to conduct our next remembrance, led by to recite the exhortation, followed by the last post of silence and republic. Royal British Legion Lee Park Campbell, led by John Grace. Royal British Legion Riders Band, and Royal British Legion Banger by Bobby Lamont. Royal Highland Fusiliers Veterans Front, William Brown. Royal Highland Fusiliers Veterans Scotland, William Scobie. And the Scottish Division, Bob Calder and Roy Fleming. Scott, Shane Lowry, Keane's own Scottish Borders, Jimmy Drysdale, and the Black Watch Association, David McKendrick. Friends of the Fallen Belfast, Davy Hagan, Bob the Bugler, Pipe and Accordionist, George Spence, and the Belfast Storm Association. Special race to be led by Tommy Alderton and Phileas Sloan. Members of that. If there's others you wish to lay wreaths, please come forward. Those wreaths were led on behalf of the Packy and the Cake families by Donna, Alexander and Danny and the Eggers. Land and in the air. Lord, may our hearts have been lifted on our burdens ease because of your presence with us at this service today. And may God grant to the living grace to depart at rest, to the Church, the Queen, the Commonwealth, and all people, peace and concord unto us and all his servants, life everlasting, and the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with you and remain with you always. Amen. Nice one.
We long.
Home, everyone.